Welcome to Research Technique Series. Research scholars, please note each research problem, whether medical, engineering, natural sciences, social sciences, including economical, human behavior, and psychological. They are all unique in nature. Each problem needs to be handled and analyzed with specific methodology. Each technique which I am going to take is general in nature and should be used under expert advice if you are a beginner. Learn the techniques and use your expertise specific to your problem wherever required. Happy learning. Thank you. Today, we have with us Dr. Nitin Kubde. Dr. Nitin Kubde is special for us as he is PhD in management and pursuing PhD in mechanical engineering. He is teacher and he is student. His dual multidisciplinary approach is the attraction for today's talk. He is Masters of Engineering in Mechanical Engineering from Sardar Patel College of Engineering, University of Mumbai. He is MBA in Marketing from RTM Nagpur University. He is MMS in Operations Management from University of Mumbai. He was awarded PhD in Management for the thesis, A Study of Development and Analysis of Plasma and Liquid Crystal Display, LCD TV industry, and its impact on color cathode ray tube TV market, with special reference to Mumbai, under the guidance of Dr. Mukul Burgate from Dhanvante National College, Nagpur, and University is RTM Nagpur University. Now he is pursuing PhD for an exploratory study of the variation in CBG output from a biogas plant by feeding raw materials in different proportions and finding a standardized process and supply chain towards economic output under the guidance of Dr. Nitin Gulhane from VGTI Mumbai, University of Mumbai. If we see his card, his degrees are 10 times more than his name. He is expert in operations management, project management, quantitative techniques in operations, productivity techniques, operation research techniques, technology management, materials management, research methods in business management, data analytics with SPSS, world-class manufacturing and mechanical engineering and other industrial engineering. He was awarded the best teacher for outstanding performance in teaching by an institute from Mumbai. He has attended and conducted various programs like AutoCAD program, entrepreneurship development program, SPSS data analysis programs, concurrent conventions on case study, business research methods, joyful professionalism, case study based management development program. Welcome, sir, on this channel.
Thank you, sir. You
have excellent approach, excellent research experience in so many areas, marketing, operations, mechanical engineering, and economical issues also. I will say you are multidisciplinary and multifaceted personality with integrated approach. I hope with today's talk with you, students will learn a lot. Thanks for giving time to this channel. Please enlighten us how multidisciplinary approach is helping you and what you will guide to the students.
Yeah. Well, first of all, I must appreciate you, sir, being into teaching industry since more than two decades, serving the teaching industry. I must appreciate this for this initiative where you are putting people like us and putting in light and giving more respect rather, isn't it? Otherwise, normally a teacher is always a kind of person who is grooming the people on the stage just by leaving himself at the backstage. So I must thank you and appreciate for this initiative for bringing people like us on the stage who are always behind the stage, and I'm thankful for that. Second part, being a resource person, having such a great research background, you have started this initiative in the larger interest of the masses, in the larger interest of the freshers who are getting into their PhD programs, any research work. That itself is a great thing, and that should be the approach of life. What I would say, that whatever we have taken from the society, now you feel it's a time to give it back to the society. So I will put it in that way. So once again, thank you very much. Coming to the basic question which you have asked, most of the times people are under the confusion, why are you getting into multidisciplinary aspects? You are a mechanical engineer, then MTech, then again going into management, again coming back to the engineering projects, handling various techno-commercial projects. So what exactly you are going to gain out of that? So that is the major question, not only asked by you, but many people. Normally you will find qualification wise people are, adopting a particular stream and just get along with that, rather than getting into a multidisciplinary approach. So the reason behind that is, first of all, during this changing scenario in the market, first, the commercial reason I would express. So during this entire changing scenario, the role of specialized people is anyways it is there. But at the same time, industries are in need of people where one person can serve the purpose of many aspects. Maybe having multi-dimensional kind of background, where rather than employing three people, four people at a time and spending 50,000 on each, they always prefer to employ a person who can handle all these four aspects, and they don't mind in offering 1,000. So in a way, commercially we will say they are saving their 1 lakh rupees per month. And at the same time, the person who is getting employed, he is also getting for the value for his efforts. So he is also happy. That is the first reason, commercial reason, where everyone should nowadays one should take into consideration. Second aspect is that when we are getting into multidisciplinary aspect, automatically that learning attitude generates, and that automatically gives you a feedback. Okay, these are the things which are existed which I do not know. Most of the times after gaining PhD, this, that, etc., people get into a kind of phobia that I know everything and you don't know anything. That's the kind of attitude. So when we are getting into a kind of multidisciplinary approach, we understand there are people who are more knowledgeable, more experienced, and it's an opportunity for you to learn something out of that, and you can keep on adding many dimensions to your personality. So of course, it is a personal call. And the third important reason, that the time will come in academics also, where you must have seen universities are already putting their efforts to, and again, even in this changing education system, the time will come where the student would be getting a choice of selecting his own preference in terms of courses, in terms of subjects. You will not surprise, on one side the student is learning engineering, on another side learning economics. On one side he is learning maybe on some finance management, another side he is taking HR also, or some other discipline, maybe psychology kind of thing. So the days are not ahead where as an academician, as a teacher, one has to be ready, one has to be prepared with all such kind of challenges, where I think there would be a better scope for people having multidisciplinary background. So these are the reasons, I guess, people should understand. I mean, the young budding entrepreneurs, young teachers, young researchers, research scholars should consider all these things, and they should not hesitate for any multidisciplinary aspect. Most of the time people are saying that is not my cup of tea, I will not be able to do. But unless and until you get into water, how will you learn swimming? So just by keeping on the bank of the river, you can't get into, unless you get into turbulent water, you won't be able to be a better swimmer.
Sometimes people are afraid that they should not open a Pandora box, and their objectives may not be focused when they go into multi-disciplines. But I have seen your work. You are quite focused. Your objectives are very focused. But what do you advise the students, which area they should enter into it? What are the hot areas which you will advise to the students?
So looking into, basically I work into, one is the marketing, second is operations management, third is technology management, then world-class manufacturing. So basically my area of working is more of manufacturing, productions, operations, mechanical engineering, and to some extent marketing also. So if you look into even current pandemic situation, you will find the companies are changing their strategies and policies very fast. Of course, towards the economic performance. Ultimately, if they want to survive in this competition, definitely in such pandemic situation, they are changing their strategies, policies, and everything. The reason behind, there are certain areas which is changing the market as well. For example, consumer behavior. Now people do not want to go out to purchase anything. They want everything to be available at their doorstep. So that's a great change in psychology. If companies are not matching with that requirement, they are nowhere. So one is consumer behavior. That is one area. Of course, marketing itself is a, you know, evergreen area, I would say, where lot of turbulence, lot of changes, lot of, you know, all kind of updations are, you know, get going on every now and then. So this is one area. One is consumer behavior. Second is the product development. That is another area which is, you know, in a, you know, limelight, where people, the researcher, should get into, understand, just perform the survey, perform the interview, online interviews, and just get into the details as to what kind of product our customer is really admiring, really accepting. What is the reason for rejection? Product life cycle. Earlier days, it used to be a longer one. Now the product life cycle has reduced down. So why it has reduced down? So before you enter in the market with your product, with your services, you must know what is the life of that, how long will it take, at what time exactly you should start for R&D and further development of the same product with add-on features, so that your product will not get declined. These are all the areas in marketing where I personally feel that there is a need for further R&D, research and development, and I think researchers should take up that area. The second area, which is my own area which I'm practicing, that is operations area, operations management. So in operations management, the major concern nowadays is not all about the how do you run the company. It's all about the operating expenses, where with reducing sales turnover, reducing profits, I am not able to have a control on operating expenses. I have to manage this entire factory with the existing manpower. Again, there is a retrenchment, this, that happening, but at the same time, there are good companies, MNCs, which are not of the opinion of any retrenchment, and they are maintaining the status quo. But for them, it's a challenging task when people are reluctant in accepting the new technology. Neither they are techno-savvy. Companies do not want to, you know, reduce the manpower. So ultimately, it's an add-on burden in terms of operating expenses. Their wages are there. Monthly wages are there. To compensate that, during this slowdown period, they are not able to even meet to the average sales turnover. That's the fact. So in doing so, companies need people not to maintain the show, but companies need people. How can you reduce down all these expenses? How can you control upon the cost? How cost controlling is possible? One way is technological inclusion. The moment higher technologies will include, automatically that manual working will get converted into semi-automatic may get converted into automatic, and there will be a reduction in time and efforts, productivity will increase. Of course, market scenario is, you know, market is opening slowly. So hopefully the situation will restore in the near future. But at the same time, these are the certain burning areas where the budding researchers should understand, they should consider this point. Again, transportation is another concern. Transportation costs need to be controlled. There are many softwares coming in for logistics and supply chain, but at the same time, sustainability of the company depends on how can you establish a control on the transportation cost, which is another burning issue. The total effect is coming on making price of the product and services as well. And in that situation, unless and until we establish a control on making price by controlling all these aspects, the future of that company, survival of that company is very difficult. So I think these are the areas I think freshers should look into.
Wonderful. Now, suppose a young researcher who just starts his research work, what you will advise him that he should take care of all these things?
Correct. So these are the focus areas, which we are calling it as a thrust areas, isn't it? Apart from that, to enter into any of these aspects, maybe it is HR, marketing, finance, operations, engineering, any stream of engineering, what is important is nowadays I found there is not that enough review of literature. Maybe because the researcher is in hurry, or he is under the impression he knows everything. And rather than, you know, data mining, you know, digging out the past information, understanding it properly, learning it properly, the researcher is not that equipped to perform further research. And in doing so, sometimes it goes into duplication of work. The work which has already been done is taken up by the fresh researcher. He is doing it. After going halfway, his guide is saying, beta, this has already been done by someone. You understand the concept of global village. Now in this global village, you should not only dig out the data for India or only Bangladesh or Pakistan, but you have to get the data from France, Germany and Europe. So these are the things which we are lagging over there. So that's the first and foremost advice which I will give, that yes, be patient. Have a patience and just find out the literature related with that and perform sufficient review of literature.
Good.
That's the most important thing.
Very nice.
After performing review of literature, automatically, needless to say, he would be able to understand these are the areas which are already been performed and these are the gaps, these are the areas which are yet to perform. So he would be able to understand and perform a gap analysis, finding out the variables. And then after, they should work upon all these variables as to what way it has to be done. Again, there is in every research paper, you will find there is a title at last or the concluding part of the every research paper, that future scope for future research, that everyone need to be understood and learn properly. Sometimes what happen, we are learning and understanding a research paper of 2010, which is of not current context, and based on that we just interpret certain things. So right from 2010 to 2020, what had happened, that need to be also understood. Then only you will be able to perform, carry it forward from 2020 onwards. And you were in 2021, your research would be something new, which will give a new dimension. We will really sort out the problems of the industry. That's one part. So here I would like to just quote the research which I am working upon. This is the research, actually it's a Petroleum Ministry's initiative, and there is a site called as SATAT, S-A-T-A-T. People should go on that, collect the information. So it is about the manufacturing of compressed biogas. Nowadays we are getting the gas which is called as CNG, compressed natural gas, having the same chemical formulation, but manufacturing this gas, the reason behind, in India, hardly all these living these metro cities like Mumbai and Pune, if you go beyond that, you won't be able to fill up CNG in your vehicle, and you have to drive the vehicle with your petrol. And the expenses are exactly double. So when you are able to manage it economically, but as because CNG pumps are not there, why pumps are not there? CNG gas is not there. So there is a huge demand across India where we have to produce CNG, CBG for cooking at our household work, at our home, for cooking the food, for pumping gas in our vehicle, four wheeler, where requirement is huge. And in such a huge demand, supply is hardly negligible. We can say it may not cater to even 10 to 20% requirement. So in such an untapped area where demand is still there, I have started working on that. And major problem which I found over as far as this project is concerned, it's not the problem related with market. There is a huge demand. Problems are availability of raw material. We are going to manufacture this gas with the help of biomass. Whatever agricultural residue waste is there in our farms, that is used over there. Then another cow dung is there. Wastage from sugar industries. Again, that is another problem for challenge for the sugar industry, where to dispose of. So just by purchasing that wastage, or they are ready to give freely also, that can be utilized. So availability of material is one part. Then the cost effective production. So cost effective production output is another part, difficulty. And third difficulty, which is major difficulty, financiers, financing agencies. Government of India has taken the initiative, but as a middle class person, as a capitalist, that is not the matter. But as a middle class person, definitely even after overcoming these two difficulties, one is the availability of raw material and second is the cost effective production, where the profitability is going above 50%, still I am waiting for the financiers. I'm not able to get the financiers, which might be the case with any middle class person. So in spite of finding and solving these difficulties, having technology in hand, having the entire project in hand, financing agencies need to finance. And that, of course, in such pandemic situation, there is obviously a conservative approach from the financing agencies, from the financial institutions, private financiers. But with this interview, I would like to just appeal them that my mobile number is 9869550575 and another number is 9320934093. I would be ready to satisfy all their doubts through my presentation. Technology is ready, project is ready, and it is on a launch pad waiting for financial help. So this is one example I just would like to quote in front of these budding researchers, that why can't they search for such kind of projects? These are the thrust areas, these are the potential areas. Right. Although that financial problem will definitely sort it out in a short time period. But this is where you will find, this is one industry where you don't have to search for market. There is a huge demand, untapped market is there. And because of that, we are not able to run our vehicle all across India. We can run our CNG vehicle only in Pune and Mumbai, not beyond that. And it's a more than 40 to 50% cost effectiveness.
Right.
These are the areas where youngsters should look into.
Nice.
Yes, sir.
What about the data analysis part? So many things. What will you advise for data analysis? To start with, they should know some basics. What are the things which you will like to advise?
Before responding to this question, I would like to divert their attention towards more and very important area, is that most of the times I found the data collection method, first of all, getting the authentic data. Because that story starts from getting the authentic data. If your data itself is not authentic, then the further process, whatever scientific way you are following, that error will aggravate and ultimately you will end up with wrong results. So authentic data. source of authentic data, collection method. As far as my project is concerned, my research work is there. I have gone to many people, interviewed them. They are the experts and big people in that particular area, where probably if I'm handing over the question, they won't be able to respond. They won't be, because they don't have that much time. So I have to take the appointments, going over there, having informal interviews, collecting the information, gathering the data. That is the first and foremost job which I had to do. So data collection method, interview is not the only method. There are many methods which need to be followed based on the type of research. And after data collection method, collect the authentic data, minimize the errors, arrange the data in a proper format. That's one part. After this, they can select many data analysis method. Many other softwares are available, like SPSS is there, which is well known, universally accepted. Even their versions, small versions are available on the internet, where they can practice upon. Many workshops are going on SPSS. Then there is another called as SAS, SAS, that is also available. Then big data analytics itself, this data analytics itself is a special domain in the area of research. So it might not, I won't be in a position to explain in short time, but yes, big data analytics, SAS, SPSS. Then there are different methods like R is there, Python is there in our operations, we are using regularly. And it is quite possible for the analysis. So analysis nowadays is happening with the help of softwares, because we are handling a big data. What is important over here is your data should be authentic, free from errors. Then there are experts in market. Sometimes it happens that you are not used to, and everyone is not expected to be expert in all in the entire research process. So you can get it done from the experts. You have your guides available who are expert in data analysis. Of course, there has to be a learning attitude. The moment you get into, automatically what will happen, you will get the flavor of data analysis. And data analysis is such an addiction, I would quote it as an addiction, that once you get into, you will automatically, you needless to say, you will get into this area, that area. Okay, I can go for regression, I can go for correlation, I can go for Z-test, I can go for T-test, I can, you know, solve this particular hypothesis with the help of this test because the sample size is this. Many things are there, where if at all students or this budding researcher, if they are attending any one workshop, even that is more than enough for them to understand the analysis. And I would say analysis thoroughly, it can't be learned by only attending the workshops. After attending the workshop, it is the initiative of the student, it is the initiative of the research scholar who has to practice at home. It is a practice oriented area. Nothing great in that, only we need to spend time on that. And after spending time, you will find valuable output, quality output will automatically come, which will be addressing to your problems. So you have identified the problem, there is a gap analysis, understood the variable, then after hypothesis, before that objectives, hypothesis, then after that you just design your mode of operandi of collecting the data by designing a sample size. And then the last part is the data analysis, which is not that difficult the way we consider it as. Because nowadays no one is going to ask you what is the formula for correlation analysis, how to find out correlation coefficient, R kaise nikalte, no one is going to ask. But the fundamental must be known to us. If R is greater than 1, R is equal to 0, R is less than, then what is the interpretation? It is just like a palmist who is seeing your palm and finding your entire, just plotting your Janma Kundali, and then he is giving so many calculations and interpretations and all these things. So what is important over here is that it is a practice oriented area, nothing more than that. Once you practice, definitely I can, you know, guarantee you that you would be able to do it. Again, this data analysis is varying from area to area. If you are doing a research on consumer behavior, and if you are doing a research on cost effectiveness, how to bring cost effective product, how to reduce down the making price of a product, the analysis techniques are different. That is the project of marketing, this is the project of operations. So ultimately it is an ocean, and in that ocean, even in data analysis, you will find expertise in data analysis in marketing only, expertise data analysis in operations, HR research, finance research. So it is the time where you will practice upon, and automatically you will gain an expertise upon that. Okay.
Thank you, Dr. Nitin Kufre. Your words, your talks will really help the students. They will help the PhD aspirants. They will help the even MA level students, ME students, MBA students. You have really enlightened us with your words, and your approach is appreciated by all, and I am thankful to you for coming on this channel. I am really obliged.
Thank you.
So nice of you. So nice of you. Great.
Thank
you very much. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Dr. Nitin Kubre says, after getting their PhD degree, people perceive either they don't know anything or know everything. Actually, they should take it as an opportunity to learn more. Today's economic environment needs multidisciplinary approach in research. This is not my cup of tea approach should be discarded. Add many dimensions to your personality and innovation approach. Education system is developing, and students will get multiple chance in multiple areas. Academicians should also be ready for such challenges in multidisciplinary approach. Engineers will learn economics, economists will learn medicines. Medical and engineering are already integrated. You may submit your research work at Journal of Global Economy, rcssindia.org. Your work is evaluated by peers with double-blind methodology. You will get comments for your work. Thank you.